They say that a moment of sadness is longing for God. Then what do you call eternal sadness? Is it one poet's bread? Or does it belong to ones who are meant to roam in the vastness of their feelings? From one extreme unto the next, I fill my heart up to the brim with laughter, brews, and medicines. But in the end, I'm left alone, and stillness deep within like Narcissus. My eyes are looking at the lake, but they don't see the lake, they miss the lake, they only see oneself. What's there inside? The inner king? The temple of sweet emptiness? What do you call the distance between the stars? Are those thoughts wise? Or they're coming from afar? Ahead of me, and water up above. Am I on the sea floor looking up? The ship floating on the surface is like a dream. It floats without caressing a single wave. What do you call the space between the ship and the wave? The poet always wonders. The things I see sometimes abandon me because my soul leaves me for a while to roam the desert. Then it returns and narrates to me the visions of perfectly still life without a sound. Yet I observe the things around, I walk ahead into the space. The space within, I release the tension of a clown. I listen to the words, they fall from fingertips onto the keyboard and on the screen. No meaning, just to let it go. To poke a hole inside that vacuum of sadness. To let it all flow like a river. A little paper boat headlining the procession of my thoughts. Now, I'm okay. I can keep going. Can go on and walk around and do the deeds and chores and watch the screens and magazines. I can do this. I know I'm strong. My heart has emptied itself. I feel nothing. And yet, I'm a vessel full of time. I dive inside. The understanding is left behind. I think, and therefore I am. I make eternal sound.